public. Thank you. Now, please imagine that you are speaking in public in a language that you did not speak growing up. Believe me, that is much, much worse. Doing so 100% guarantees that you will be exposing your imperfection. Researchers say that in order for you to be completely fluent in a language, the learning should start before the age of 10. I came to the United States when I was 26. I worked as a programmer after graduating from college in Japan. And I moved there to learn English, the language that was spoken in a country that was leading the IT industry. After 3 years of working as a programmer, I signed up for a cultural exchange program in the United States. And I left the job to join the program. I was assigned to a high school in Philadelphia to introduce Japanese culture there. So I gave one class a day in a high school. The program came with a homestay arrangement, and I stayed with an American family. The couple had a two years old daughter. And my English was worse than hers. That was embarrassing. What kind of college-educated person cannot speak as well as 2 years old? I couldn't clarify myself as well as 2 years old. That was so embarrassing. I spoke as little as possible. At school, I just let my students talk. At home, I avoided my host family and stayed in my bedroom most of the time. Naturally, nearing the end of the program, several months later, my English was not improved at all. I still wanted to learn English before returning to Japan. I enrolled in a business school nearby and extended my stay in the United States. Even the introductions in the first classes made me so nervous, I wanted to run away. In the finance class, in the first semester, I raised my hand to answer a question. However, when the professor pointed at me, I realized that I didn't know how to say $100,000. Therefore, I said 100000. And see, everybody laughed. That was not a mean laugh, but everybody laughed. And I stopped participating in classes. Then, a few semesters later, in an accounting class, the professor returned the test result and said, Susie got the highest, 98, just missing one question. Second highest is 75. Whole class turned to me, surprised and confused. The person in front of me said to me, how did you do that, 98? And I knew that he was also thinking, but you don't even speak English and you look stupid. That was my turning point. I became the top student in an accounting, statistics, and in any other math-oriented classes. And two of my classmates asked me to tutor them. Tutoring college-educated native English speakers? I couldn't believe that. I met with them in the school library and taught them how to solve this problem and how to use this formula and that. Now I knew that I was still confident and my intelligence was still intact despite my very limited English skills. I started participating in classes and and I even started socializing. And finally, my English started improving, little by little. Now, years later, as you can tell, my English is still far from perfect. However, I am not afraid of my imperfection to be seen. I came to the United States all the way from Japan by myself, and I established myself in a country whose language I didn't speak growing up. My accent is a sign of my courage. Being imperfect means that you are trying something new. Being imperfect means that you are challenging yourself. We should be all brave enough to be imperfect.